Hi, this is JP from Now the Lights Over Arkham. This time we are continuing Sister Mary's run through the Return to Dunwich Legacy campaign. Last time we managed to save all of the allies that were underneath the agenda deck in the Blood on the Altar scenario. So I debated if I will add everybody to the deck because that will blow the deck up quite a bit. So in the end, I decided to add them all, but I made some changes with the 4xp to the deck, so let's look at the changes first. To make room for some new cards, I removed one evidence, David Renfield, Second Wind and Premonition. I added one copy of extra ammunition to help me load up the Winchester or the 45 if I'm running out of ammo. Then I added the new cards from the Devil Wreath Mythos pack, the Radiant Smites. They are really good in Sister Mary. And because now I have really bloated the deck with allies, I decided to add one Calling in Favors into the deck. So if I have a ally that I'm not needing that much in play, and I need to find an ally that I would rather have in play, I can use the Calling in Favors to change the allies. Then, because of the scenario, we had to add one basic weakness, madness, pact or injury into the deck, and I hit a Tykophobia, which penalizes us if we fail tests. But those are basically the changes in the deck. Let's see what we are facing in the scenario. Because we managed to rescue everybody in the last scenario, we are starting with two broods in play. One in the Cold Springs Glen and one in the Blasted Heath. And because we are playing the returned version, we have one basic Brood of Yog-Sothoth in play, and then we have the altered versions which came in the return to set. So we have the Charging Beast version, which is really nasty. It moves quite a lot, and this is usually a scenario that if it's not going really well, I might just resign. But let's see, I'm for the sake of making an entertaining video, I decided to at least try to kill one brood. And we have five clues on the Powder of Ibn Ghazi, which will help immensely if we just manage to get to the Wheatley Ruins to cash in our two clues to get the esoteric formula, so we can start fighting the brutes with those with our willpower. But yeah, I think that's enough of the deck and scenario. Last thing in setup, we add a two Bless tokens into the Chaos pack, and we are ready to start, so let's get going. I have pre-shuffled the deck, so let's draw our opening hand. Okay, so we redraw the Crisis of Fate. So we get Radiant Smite. I think I'll keep that. I keep the Guardian Spirit. I'll keep the Scene of the Crime. And I think I'll mulligan those two. Okay, so we get the Hallowed Mirror and Rite of Sanctification. So, no Winchester, but in this scenario we are not able to fight with the Winchester either way. So, if we get a random enemy from the encounter deck, we at least have the Radiant Smite in hand. And I think I'll start by playing down the Rite of Sanctification, so we can start playing stuff with a discount. I think 2 is enough, so I'll play that. So we fish. Just for now, I'll try to remember the adding of the Blessed Token at the end by putting it onto my deck. So I'll seal two bless tokens onto the Rite of Sanctification. I'll immediately use one of them to discount a card by two. So I'll play the Guardian Angel into play. Just debating where I would like to put it. It's okay there. So that's the second action. And last action, I think we are trying to investigate. Actually, let's back up. My first action, I play the scene of the crime. So I'll just grab one clue as a first action. And then play the Rite of Sanctification, then use the Rite of Sanctification. So we have Hallowed Mirror and Radiant Smite in hand. Okay, I'll just have to recheck. So at the end of the enemy phase, move each Brood of Yog-Sothoth enemy once towards a random location. So it happens at the end. And yeah, we need two clues to advance, and we need to do it in the Waitley Ruins. So enemy phase, nothing happens. At the end of the enemy phase, we randomize where the broods move. So I'll shuffle these and pick the card at the bottom to be the place where broods move. So we start with the Brood of Yog-Sothoth that is in Blasted Heat. So let's shuffle this and it moves to Devil's Hopyard. Then we randomize this, and this actually has the special ability. Brood of Yog-Sothoth forced after Brood of Yog-Sothoth moves for the first time each round. If it's unengaged, it immediately moves again towards a random location. So basically this guy moves twice if it's not engaged. Okay, so first place it moves is 10-acre meadow, and then it moves again. And Gold Spring Glen, so it just basically shuffled back and forth. And that is the enemy phase ending. Upkeep, we draw a card. We get another Scene of the Crime, which is really useful for next turn. We get one resource and we add the bless token into the back. Just put one next turn. Okay, so that is the first turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom to the agenda and the threshold is 5. First encounter card is, it's the Lupin Troll. Spawn farthest location from you. Prey lowest agility hunter, retaliate. Okay. So the farthest location is the Devil's Hopyard. Place it there. Okay, first action, this should have read it. I'll use this to return one bless token into the back. This gets removed, and I'll cheapen this Scene of the Crime by 2. So we grab another clue from here. And then remaining last actions, I'll just move to 10-acre meadow. I can do a fast triggered ability here. You set a bait using the alive animal. Each investigator at 10-acre meadow may place one of his or her clues on an abomination enemy in the 10-acre meadow. Okay, and there are 3 clues here. And last action, I'll just move to Whitley Ruins. This guy will hunt, but I'll just kill it next turn with the Radiant Smite. And three round location with 2 clues. Each investigator in Whitley gets minus 1 willpower. First trigger ability, you hurl a nearby canister of paint at the monster. An investigator in Weedly Ruins may place up to three of his or her clues on an abomination enemy in Weedly Ruins, group limit once per game. And we will spend the two clues here right away. So we get obtaining the formula. If Dr. Armitage survived the Dunwich legacy, each investigator puts into play one set aside esoteric formula. So we'll just place it here. And then objective, defeat as many Brood of Yog-Sothoth enemies as you can. If there are no copies of Brood of Yog-Sothoth in play or set aside, advance. And we have we still have three here, two in play, so we need to defeat five, but I think I'm maybe defeating two maximum and just resigning. But it, we'll see when we get there. And the esoteric formula, action fight. This attack uses willpower instead of fight. You get plus two willpower for this attack for each clue on the attacked enemy. Use this ability only on an abomination enemy. And these all are abominations. I think only the Whipper will set is not abominations. But yeah, enemy phase. This enemy hunts here. It engages us and hits us for one damage. I'll put it on the Guardian Angel. That adds one clue to the back, one bless token into the back, and we take one horror. And then at the end of the enemy phase, we start from this one. Just move this looping roll here. Easier for me to see. Okay, so the first brood moves to Dunwich Village. So the shortest way to Dunwich Village is just going back here. Then this guy moves. And Dunwich Village. And as it's not engaged, it moves again. Weedly Ruins, so it comes once towards here. Okay, well, we go to upkeep, we draw a card, we get the Winchester, a bit late, but we're not needing it at the moment. We can maybe play it later. We add one bless token in the bag. And that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add another Doom to the agenda. Hunter card is a Whipper Will. It's aloof, hunter, spawns at our location. Well, that is quite annoying, so to say. So we get minus one to everything. We have this looping troll in play. I may use willpower instead of strength here, but as my willpower and strength are equal at the moment, I think I'm just as a first action hitting the looping troll with the Radiant Smite, and I'm using three bless tokens from the back, and I'm using combat. So I get plus three to the combat check. Just fishing up. So we seal three bless tokens here. And we are hitting six versus four. I have nothing to commit to the test. So we're just hoping to hit. This deals enough damage to kill it straight away, which is the objective, to get rid of this. We have minus one from the Whipper Will, so we are actually five versus five versus four, yeah. Okay, so five versus four, the chaos pack says an elder sign, so we get to add one, and because this hits, these all get returned to the bag, and this deals plus one damage for plus one damage and plus one skill for each blessed token, so it deals four damage, so this guy is totally dead. Second action. I think I am moving to the Cold Spring Glen. And it's too short location. Zero clues each enemy. Oh yeah, I totally forgot to add the clues here. So each enemy in Cold Spring Glen gets minus one evade. Fast triggered ability. After Cold Spring Glen is chosen as a random location, an investigator in close can test agility 3. If successful, choose a different random location. Okay. And actually, last action. Just in case, I'll play the Winchester. So if we have to deal with the Viper Wheel or something, we have a good weapon to deal with it. And it gets 5 ammo on it. So, enemy phase, the Viper will hunt here, doesn't engage, it's aloof. End of the enemy phase, we start with the green, the Brood of Yog-Sothoth. It moves spawns towards Dunwich village, where it's arrived there. Then the charging beast version. First move is to 10 acre meadow. It is already there. It moves again. Cold Spring Glen. And actually, I'll just let it move here. We try to kill it next turn. Okay, that is the enemy phase. We go to upkeep. We add one bless token, we draw a card, and we gain one resource. That is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add Doom to the agenda. The card is sorted and silent. Attached to sorted and silent to your location. Forced at the end of the round, each investigator at that location takes one horror. When the agenda advances, discard sorted and silent. Okay, well, let's just add it there. Okay, first action. As a free action, I'll just pump. We are willpower 3 versus 5, so let's see. Don't do this close. Yeah, this should need to be exhausted. Okay, well, I forgot that we need to have this guy exhausted. So we try to evade it. It gets minus one evade here, so I'll commit this water protection to the test. We are evading. 4 versus 3. It's a blessed token, so we are 6 versus 3. another blessed token, 8 versus 3, so another, okay, so we have to Sacred Covenant this, and a minus 1, so we'll Sacred Covenant all of these back, so we are evading 4, 3 versus 3. This is evaded. Now we can pump 3 clues on it. Okay, then we will. No, we actually, there's the Whipper Will. We have to spend one of the clues, the best tokens. Damn Whipper Wills. So I'll just spend one of the best tokens. Then we'll attack. I am attacking. I'm using the esoteric formula. So we are attacking 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 versus 5. We hit. We deal 1 damage. And last action, we'll hit again. And same, we are 9 versus 5. And it's a plus 1, so this root is dead. We'll remove these clues and these tokens. Add this root to the victory display. Just place it over here. Well, at least we got one root killed. At the end of the turn, we are at the Sorbit and Silent location, so I'll take one horror. Whipper Will does nothing. We move the remaining brood. So let's see where it goes. So it moves back to the blasted heat. Okay, well, we go to upkeep, we draw a card, we get Dr. Henry Armitage, then we gain one resource and we added the blessed token. Okay, so that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We are at 4 of 5 doom, and counter card for this turn is another Whipper Will. Well, of course. Little guys are annoying as hell. Well, I think we're running away from them. So I think this turn I'll play Henry Armitage. Actually, I think I could keep Henry Armitage because I can use it to help me evade the other brood, so I can dump those on. Yeah, that sounds like a plan. Okay, so we'll just move. I'll move here. I'll move to the Devil's Hop Yard. It's a one shard location, two shards location with one clue. First triggered ability, the creature follows you into the mud. Each investigator in Devil's Hop Yard may place one of his or her clues on an abomination enemy in Devil's Hop Yard in once per game. So without exhausting, we can get one clue here. Well, I'll try to grab this clue here. So I'm investigating two versus two, yeah. Okay, so not a big chance. Actually, this would have been ready. So let's see, we hit a bless or something, we can grab this clue. It's a plus one, so we grab this clue. Enemy face this hunt here. Let's see where the other one go. The brood goes. Okay, so it moves to Cold Spring Glen. The shortest way to Cold Spring Glen is 1, 2, 1, 2. Okay, so I decided to go this way. So it's at my location for next round, so I can try to kill it. And we got upkeep, we draw a card, we get 45 automatic, we gain one resource and add one bless into the bag. So we have 8 bless tokens in the bag at the moment. And that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We are at 5 doom, so we advance the agenda. Calmity strikes. Shuffle the encounter reserve pile into the encounter deck. Spawn one of the set aside Brood of Yog-Sothoth enemies at a random location if able. So let's first determine one random Brood enemy. So we spawn this one, and it's the Amorphous Terror. Special thing about this: after Brood of Yog-Sothoth enters your location or vice versa, just with part 3, if you fail, take one horror. Okay, then we'll figure out where it enter spawns. So it spawns in the Dunwich village. And I'll mark it with this yellow one. Okay, and we shuffle the encounter discard pile, which is a whopping one card. This actually this discard, so it goes into the encounter deck. I think we are out of gas after we defeat this root, so we just might resign next turn. There's no point in trying to get more trauma by killing the third one, but we'll see how this goes. And counter card for this turn is Towering Beasts. Attached to a Brood of Yog-Sothoth enemy in play, if that enemy is at your location, take one damage. Attached enemy gets plus one fight, plus one health. So we'll put it on this one because we probably won't be killing that one. And that is the Mythos phase. We go to Investigation phase. We'll use this ability to put this on this. Just shuffle this Brood closer. So we put this clue here. Then we'll try to evade. I'm using the 45 automatic and Herb Armitage for the test. I'm evading 6 versus 3. It's a tablet 0. Okay. So we have to remove this clue. That is unfortunate. But still we evade it. And we can pump this onto it. Well, nothing we can do about that. So second action, we'll attack. We use the esoteric formula. I will just hit, so I'm hitting. Eight versus six. So it's a minus one. We deal one damage. Last action, I'll commit the hallowed mirror. So we are hitting 9 versus 6. It's a blessed token. and it's a skull. And it's a minus two. So use the covenant. We still hit. So this goes into the bag and this is dead. Add it into the victory display. Well, we managed to kill at least two, so that's a good result in my book for this scenario. This really is a tough scenario. I have never killed more than three, I think, and that's with a really, really good deck. Okay, enemy phase. The Viper will hunt here. Move the Brood of Yog-Sothoth that is in the damaged village. And it moves to Blasted Heat. Okay, well, it's unfortunate. I think we're just running past it either way to resign. And that is the enemy phase done. We go to upkeep, we draw a card, we get drawn to the flame. We add less token into the bag and we gain one resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom onto the agenda. The encounter card is Looping Troll. Father's location is 2, 1, 2. Just spawn it at the Gold Spring Glen. We are definitely resigning this turn. There is just too much happening on the map, and this guy has 3 health and plus 1 fight, so it's really unlikely we could even kill it. First action, I'll move here, I'll take a willpower 3 test, I commit the Drawn to the Flame to the test. 4 versus, yeah, this is ready. So 5 versus 3. Plus 1. Then I will move, so I'll take an attack of opportunity. I'll take 1 damage on Guardian Angel, put 1 less token into the bag, and 2 horror. Then, last action, I will just resign. So, we resigned, so we read, if no resolution was reached, each investigator resigned or was defeated, got resolution 1. You did all you could to stop the rampaging monsters, but there were more of them than you realized and you weren't able to slay them all. Exhausted and terrified, you retreat to Zebulon's home and hope to survive the night. In your campaign log, record that X Brood escaped into the wild, X is the number of Brood Yog-Sothoth still in play or set aside, so it's 3 copies. If an investigator's deck contains the power of Ibn Ghazir card, remove it from that investigator's deck. So we remove this. And each investigator earns experience equal to X, equal to the victory X value of each card in the victory display. And we got 2 experience from these 2 routes. So, that is the Undimensioned and Unseen. A really tough scenario, especially when you can't use your super good Winchester for killing the brutes and you have to use your wits. But that is sometimes this scenario. It's a real tough one if you're not built for it. And I'm happy I killed 2 brutes. That's a good result in my books. So hope you guys enjoyed this playthrough. Next time we are continuing into Return to Where Doom Awaits, and let's see if we can clear that scenario and advance to the last scenario of the campaign. So thanks for watching, and until next time.